Just to share with you, I think the global perspectives on financial inclusion. As on date, about 2.5 billion adults, just over a half of adult population, do not use formal financial services to save or borrow. Out of the 2.2 billion of these unserved adults live in Africa, Asia, Latin America, and Middle East. Of the 1.2 billion adults use formal financial services in Africa, Asia, and Middle East, at least two-thirds, a little more than 800 million, live on less than $5 a day. In developed nations, only 12% do not have the banking accounts, comparable to the 62% in the developing countries. So there's a wide gap between the developed and the developing countries. When it comes to the Indian context, 59% of the population only have got the deposit account. If I look at it, about 54% of them are from the rural areas and about 67% are from the urban areas. So a large chunk of the population still do not have the basic banking accounts. 9% only of these population have got credit accounts with banks. India has one of the highest number of households, 145 million, excluded from banking after China. China has got much more than us. There is only one bank per about 14,000 people. Only a little less than 20% of the population has any kind of life insurance, and 9.6% of the population has non-life insurance coverage. Just 18% has debit cards, and less than 2% has got credit cards. These statistics, staggering as they are, do not convey the true extent of financial exclusion, I would say. Even where bank accounts are claimed to have been opened, experience has shown that a larger number of these accounts are dormant. Few conduct any banking transactions, and even few receive any credit into their accounts. As per the preliminary findings on the state of the sector report for wholesome financial inclusion, the total number of no-frills accounts as on March 2011 stands at 74.3 million. But the number of active accounts reported by various banks varies between a minuscule 3% to around 20%. Millions of people across the country are therefore denied the opportunity to harness the earning capacity and entrepreneurial talent and are condemned to marginalization and poverty. So I think from there where we stand about a couple of years back, I think we are taking a paradigm shift and then moving to an inflection point, I would say, with the importance that is being given by the government as on day. We are moving to a point where the technology, the embracing of the technology for financial inclusion is becoming important. Innovating branchless models of delivery, focus from growth to inclusive growth, realizing the fact that poor are bankable and there is a responsibility for inclusive banking, importance given to sustainability, viability and the scalability rather than treating the aspect of financial inclusion as a burden for all of us, and more clarity and importance from government and regulators on financial inclusion. Having said that, I think instead of actually saying broadly on the terms of what's happening on the technological innovations in the financial inclusion space, let me briefly describe, take you through what's happening in Axis Bank, what we are doing. Probably it covers a gamut of the financial products that we are offering through in the financial inclusion space, and the various technologies that we are adopting and the various form factors we are adopting at different geographies to suit that particular clientele base or probably to suit that particular geography. And also from the coming from the point that where there is a more acceptability for that particular product, we have implemented and then we have scaled this product in those particular areas.